Aloha!
You know, I always say if you can't wake up in your own house,
then you might as well wake up in paradise.
I'm so excited that we're back
at Disney's Polynesian Village Resort. Look at that. There's the Magic Kingdom over there.
It's been a couple of years since I've stayed here. Allie has never really stayed here at all, so what better place
to start our Walt Disney World trip?
The Polynesian opened in 1971
and was one of the first two original hotels to open up at Disney World.
It's famously where John Lennon signed the papers that broke up the Beatles. It's where I signed my divorce papers.
So there's been lots of sad endings, happy endings,
and as you can see, perfect beginnings.
Since what better way is there to begin a Disney World day than looking at this?
I mean, look at this. We got the beautiful marina here where you can rent boats
and take them right out to the Seven Seas Lagoon.
You could do a little fishing,
or maybe just head out onto the dock
and catch a water launch to the Magic Kingdom.
Oh yes, lots to do on the Seven Seas Lagoon. Everything except for swimming.
No swimming allowed.
Look at these beautiful sandy beaches where the kids can play.
Lay out in the sun by day, or by night watch the fireworks at Magic Kingdom.
Wait a minute.
Look at this. The hammocks are open.
Wow, gotta get up pretty early in the morning to get one of these.
Now, even though you can't swim in the lagoon here for obvious reasons,
they've still got you covered with the pools.
They've got the lava pool out here, complete with its own volcano and waterfall.
Not to mention a very steamy hot tub.
And if the hot tub and pool with its own volcano, waterfall, and slide
aren't enough for you, the lava pool area also
has an amazing tiki-themed water playground.
I want to play. Sadly, I think I'm too big. Not too old, but just a little too big. Gotta shed my college weight.
Oh yeah, this whole area is beautiful, and what a view, huh? Magic Kingdom is over there.
I got so distracted by the wonders of the lava pool
that I almost forgot to show you the other pool.
If you're looking for something a little less crowded, a little less noisy,
then you can't go wrong with the Oasis pool.
Look at it. It's beautiful.
The mid-century style shade structures,
the way the water just comes and spills right to the edge,
and best of all, this awesome mid-century modern Polynesian pop style roof.
The perfect place for the retro-inspired Oasis Bar and Grill.
Look at those epic mid-century lamps,
funky surfboard-inspired tables.
If the lava pool playground is a kid's paradise,
then the Oasis pool is a paradise for mom and dad.
It's so beautiful out here today.
Now, the last time I spent the night at the Polynesian
was 2 years ago for Valentine's Day,
when someone hooked us up with a stay in the epic Bora Bora bungalows. That was actually the one time Allie stayed at the Polynesian.
But we checked in at night,
and trust me, once you have a bungalow here,
especially just for one night, all you want to do is stay in it.
So technically you stayed here because you stayed in the bungalow that one night, but it's not really the same as staying in the regular resort.
Because when you stay in a bungalow, you have your own mini resort all to yourself. It even has its own little miniature pool.
We'll try and link that episode down below so you can see what we mean.
Now, for those regular guests that aren't staying in these sweet Bora Bora bungalows,
there are 12 different longhouses, each named after different Polynesian islands,
and ranging in size from big to gargantuan,
each full of epic Polynesian themed rooms.
And don't worry, we'll show you ours in just a little bit.
But dude,
just check out even some of the foyers in these buildings. They're amazing. The theming is awesome.
I could live in here forever. Ever.
I forgot to mention, there is actually one sort of small-ish building,
the Niue Longhouse,
which is fitting because Niue is one of the smallest Polynesian nations
and one of the smallest countries on Earth.
Has a nice ring to it.
Niue.
Anyway, as you can see, a lot of different longhouses out here, a lot of different rooms to stay in.
Some of the buildings are newer than others, some are nicer than others, like those DVC rooms.
That's Disney Vacation Club. And some are just mind-blowing, like the Bora Bora bungalows.
But let's be honest, it could look like a Motel 6 on the inside, and I'd still want to stay here.
Because even though I love all the theming and design,
let's face it,
the main attraction to staying in the Polynesian is that it's right across the water from the Magic Kingdom.
So not only is it just a short boat ride away from that castle,
but all three hotels on the Seven Seas Lagoon, the Contemporary, the Grand Floridian, and of course the Polynesian,
are all connected to the Magic Kingdom directly by monorail.
That's right, the monorail comes directly to the Polynesian. Now you're combining everything I like.
Magic Kingdom, tiki stuff, and monorail.
Are you freaking kidding me? This place is amazing.
And look at that. It pulls up to the one building we really haven't mentioned yet.
The big one. The one with the lobby.
The Great Ceremonial House.
Not the Pretty Good Ceremonial House.
Not the Okay Ceremonial House.
The Great Ceremonial House.
This is the main entrance where the monorail station is, where you pull up with your car to check in.
People and luggage are always coming and going, checking in, checking out.
And I don't know about you, but for my money, it's one of the prettiest places at Walt Disney World, period.
Look at all the mature plants.
The sunlight pouring in through the foliage and lighting up the lagoon.
Lava rock and little waterfalls back there. I mean, is there any better way to make a first impression than this?
I don't think so.
Especially when you're greeted by this.
Just look at this lobby.
How in the world could you help getting excited when you see this?
Every inch of this place is covered in theming.
The statue of Maui is here, offering you a lei, welcoming you.
Huh?
As a matter of fact, that's where we got the leis that we're wearing.
Because the first thing that happens after you get here and check in
is you get lei.
The same exact thing happened to me when I landed in Hawaii in 1998.
But that's a story for another time.
Ooh. I mean, the ones they hand you are a little itchy and plasticky, but come on, it's all part of the fun.
You want to take yours off, don't you?
Yes.
She's wanted to take hers off all day, but I won't let her.
Dude, no matter how many times I've been in this place, I am blown away inside the Great Ceremonial House.
Dude, for starters, just look at the epic design in here.
The whole lobby was remodeled sometime around 2014,
and boy, does it look sharp.
The furniture, the plants, the giant tiki lamps in the skylight.
I just love being in here.
Dude, look, even the carpet is awesome.
You got cartoons for the kiddos in here while the adults check in.
This epic, gigantic map of the property.
Bamboo and palm trees.
And of course, tikis.
Many of the old original Polynesian resort tikis
were carved by my good friend Leroy Schmaltz of Oceanic Arts in California.
Actually, they pretty much outfitted this whole place when it opened up.
Some of the oldest ones from the 70s have been slowly disappearing over the years.
But don't worry, there's still plenty of tikis left.
Especially at the ground floor store.
Called what else?
The Boo Tiki.
Oh, yes.
Look at all these crazy guys.
Who knew that tikis could run a store?
Admittedly, some of the newer ones are a little less traditional than the older style of tiki,
such as this or some of the carvings on these poles.
Those are much more traditional, but I say bring them on. You can never have too many tikis.
Man, these little guys are everywhere.
Up on the shelves,
moving the merchandise, and even
peeking in the window. No wonder this guy's hiding.
There's a peeping Tom.
A peepee tiki.
Oh, he doesn't want him to know where he is.
That's my favorite part.
Oh, dude, look at this. This tiki's got a secret on his back.
It's a hidden Mickey.
As you can see, some Christmas merchandise has snuck its way in here. A little Melakaliki Maka stuff, if you will. Not really Polynesian resort specific.
But don't worry, they've got us covered over here with them.
They've got this epic Trader Sam's Hawaiian shirt. Tiki room ties.
Actually, they've got a lot of awesome tiki room stuff. I mean, look at that shirt. Or how about a tiki room umbrella.
Tiki mugs, Polynesian beads,
treats from the Honolulu Cookie Company. Oh, I didn't even notice the Trader Sam's dress.
Oh, Jose hats,
Jose hoodies,
shrunken head tiki drink purses, and look at this. Some art by none other than Macbeth.
Darn you, Macbeth, always making epic art
that I have no room for.
Let's see, what else do they have in here?
Ooh, plenty of Hawaiian shirts in numerous patterns and colors.
Ooh, and look, they got some Polynesian shirts.
Oh, those are awesome.
Oh, they made a new Polynesian Hawaiian shirt. Look at little Maui right there.
He's a very popular guy.
Look, he's over here on the
toothpick holders.
He's got his own light-up ornament, refrigerator magnet, sick leather keychain,
light-up statue.
Man, this guy knows how to merchandise.
Best of all, he's on these epic lamps that they actually have in some of the rooms, and you can buy it
right here in the boutique. It's pricey,
you know, because they're made especially for these rooms.
Someday, if we have a tiki room anywhere, I'm getting one.
Oh, I really like that print right there.
There's actually a lot of cool art in here.
Mostly Stitch related,
but I'll allow it.
Anyway, as you can see, we've only scratched the surface.
There's more merch in here than you can shake a tiki at.
But I guess we better be moving on,
because there's a lot of stuff to see in here.
As a matter of fact, upstairs, they've got a couple more little stores
where you can get gifts
and sundries, known collectively as the Moana Mercantile.
One side is all decked out
with all your crazy Disney character and Disney park souvenirs,
including some very large stuffed stitches.
Ooh. And the other side
is sort of like the Polynesian Resort's little mini mart.
Both of them have the same name, but they're really two separate stores.
This is where you can get your beer, man.
Or if you're me, pick up a root beer.
Got all your basic hams and bolognese,
milk and eggs,
random microwavable stuff, and of course Mickey bars,
medicine, hygiene products, booze,
Disney treats of every kind,
cigars and Doritos and bananas.
And check it out, even a book about hidden Mickeys. Oh my gosh, Chip and Joanna are having a baby.
I don't know who Chip and Joanna are,
but congratulations.
Now if you're not in the mood for candy cane popcorn, the Polynesian does of course have plenty of dining options.
There's the Kona Island Coffee and Sushi Bar,
which features such delights as dark chocolate bacon.
Ew, I only have my bacon with milk chocolate.
Bacon covered, chocolate covered strawberries. Strawberry chocolate almond sprinkled donut. What is going on here?
I think the chef was having too much of his own coffee.
And then right next door up here, you have the Kona Cafe. You got your pot stickers, your big kahuna burger, your duck fried rice.
There's all kinds of stuff.
The atmosphere is fantastic. The seating arrangements are nice.
And
the people watching opportunities are endless.
I mean, the monorail station is right there.
So there's a lot of coming and going up here.
Now, in addition to the Kona Cafe upstairs, they've also got the Tambu Lounge.
Kind of a nice, relaxing little tiki bar area.
Very mellow, lots of muted colors.
And right next door, fanciest of all.
At least in this building anyway.
Ohana, the tikiest place in the whole building. There's a veritable forest of tikis in here.
Now this is a character dining establishment,
which means that while you eat your breakfast or dinner, Disney characters come by the table
to say hello. I see Mickey back there. I see Lilo.
I mean, how awesome is that?
Oh, this is making me hungry. Right now, they're still serving breakfast in there.
But I feel like I'm way past breakfast hunger now.
I'm at lunch hunger levels. I need some meat.
Luckily, I know the perfect place because back downstairs is one of our favorite places to eat in all of Walt Disney World.
Now, I have celiac disease, so I have to eat all gluten-free.
And that is why I love coming to Captain Cook's, the quick service restaurant here at the Polynesian.
Where not only are the atmosphere, theming, and view from the windows amazing, but in addition to all the other food and snacks here,
they have the old school gluten-free chicken tenders.
They changed them in the parks, but here they still have them. My favorite. Mmm.
Oh, hot, hot.
Oh, how I missed this.
All right.
I'm so full.
But you know, another perk to eating at Captain Cook's is that just around the corner,
right by the back door of the Great Ceremonial House,
is the ultimate place to get dessert.
Serving up
Dole Whips in a cup.
And it's no longer just pineapple because they have lemon and lime.
See, Allie, when I said get one of each to try, I thought they would be a lot smaller than this.
I'm gonna need to use these giant spoons to finish these.
All right, give the lime a try. Is it good?
Sour.
Hmm. Oh, not the lemon.
Oh my gosh, that lemon is so good. Get away from me, pineapple. I don't need you anymore.
Oh my gosh. Hey, stop trying my lemon. This is mine.
You didn't even try this one.
I don't need to try that one because this one is so good.
Just taste it.
Okay, I'll try a little lime.
Mm-hmm.
Why is it so sour?
And yet I want more. Dude, you gotta put that lime in the coconut. Mix them both up.
Wait a minute, I have a great idea from the makers of Sprite.
Let's see what happens when you try lemon and lime.
Mm. Oh my god.
That
was so good.
Lemon and lime? Why has no one ever thought of this before?
Dude, speaking of these huge gargantuan spoons,
I wonder how many Dole Whips it would take to fill that up.
Giant tiki spoons full of Dole Whips.
Lemon, lime, Dole Whip.
Sorry, pineapple, you have no friends.
I'll be pineapple's friend.
Okay, you can eat that.
This reminds me, last night we went to Disney Springs really quick, and we were walking back to the grapefruit parking lot, and some guy was screaming, "Grapefruit, why isn't it called lemon? Grapefruit is a horrible fruit."
Amen, brother.
See, this is a nice day. I normally don't go so slow and chill and spend so much time at the hotel.
But recovering from this spine injury
has forced me on the chill path.
And if that means I have to eat lemon Dole Whip, well,
I'll just have to make the sacrifice.
Okay, no more.
Oh, come on, just another spoonful.
Yeah, just one more spoonful.
No.
Oh, remind me never to do that again.
I didn't think there was any such thing as too much Dole Whip.
No.
But I was wrong.
And I still didn't even finish it all. That is a dole fail.
Now at night out here behind the great ceremonial house, they light up all these torches with real flame. And they've got all kinds of activities. Sometimes they show movies out here.
Or they'll have games.
Plus, it's a great place to watch the fireworks from Magic Kingdom.
Either back there on the lawn or
right down here
on the beach.
You can play volleyball.
Have a fire, watch the fireworks.
It's all family friendly fun.
But if you're in a more adult mood, I forgot to mention
that back up here in the Great Ceremonial House,
they've also got the ultimate Disney World Tiki Bar.
Trader Sam's Grog Grotto.
It's a very popular choice, as you can see. It's not even open yet. That's just a line to get a reservation.
We're gonna try to take you guys in there today.
Well, maybe we'll come back and give that its own episode.
On a day when people are a little less thirsty.
Of course, if the inside's full, you can always try your luck at the Trader Sam's Tiki Terrace outdoors,
where you can sip your drink beside the waterfall.
Under the twinkling tiki lights, there's musicians, tiki torches, and totems.
Which, by the way, if you're a Disneyland Tiki Room fan,
some of these ought to look familiar to you.
Good old Negandhi, Hina.
All together, this all just makes you feel like you're on some crazy fantasy island in the South Pacific.
A feeling that's even more enhanced
if you're lucky enough to snag a reservation
to the jewel in the Polynesian's crown, Disney's Spirit of Aloha Dinner Show.
Oh, look at the size of that tiki.
It looks like the world's largest tiki mug. Look at it. It's over an alley tall.
Oh, I'd love to fill up this cup with a big Chief Lapu Lapu.
Wait a minute. Where was I? Oh, yes. The Spirit of Aloha.
Way over here. Way in the back past the last of the longhouses.
Hidden in this secret forest
is a purpose-built open-air theater.
They put on a whole crazy dinner show featuring traditional Polynesian dances
with singing and fire.
The whole thing is supposed to be awesome.
I have never actually managed to make it to the Spirit of Aloha.
I always forget to make a reservation in advance.
And then this time we had someone tell us they could probably finagle us a reservation.
But unfortunately, today was the only day we could have gone.
And it's the only day there's no show.
Well, there's always next time.
Yeah.
Next time.
Dude, pro tip though, during the day when there's no dinner show going on,
this little staging area and walkway
is completely deserted and gorgeous.
It's like you have your own private little tiki forest.
Look at this tree. How awesome is that?
And I think technically this is a smoking area.
So if you got a fine cigar or a bubble pipe,
this is definitely the spot to come and relax. Dang.
All right, well, I think that pretty much sums up all of the resort we can see and experience at the moment.
We'll have to leave the dinner show for a future visit,
and maybe we can combine that with a visit to Trader Sam's.
But for now, all that's left for us to do
is give you a tour of our room,
which rather conveniently is located right here,
just a few steps away from the Spirit of Aloha in the last longhouse,
Aotearoa,
which I believe is, but correct me if I'm wrong,
the Maori name for New Zealand.
Now, I don't think this particular building has got the upgrade some of the other ones we were looking at have.
No swanky foyer.
Much more old school tile and ceiling tiles. Much more muted tones than some of the other hallways we've seen today.
But I feel like that's kind of cool. Like, it gives it a little bit of an old school flavor.
All right, at the very end of the hallway in the very last longhouse,
finally,
is our room. Here it is. Our room at the Polynesian.
Oh, and it's so nice.
Kind of like the hallways, I feel like it's a little more muted and a little more old school than the last room I was in here.
But it does kind of offer a nice contrast between the fully upgraded rooms
and ones that are kind of half upgraded like this one.
Look at this beautiful art on the wall.
Two epic queen size beds
with these crazy almost hut-like headboards that include
my favorite individual dimmable lamps on either side.
Oh, that is nice.
You'll have to excuse the wrinkles.
Because after all, we did already sleep in this room.
So, you know, we've made a little bit of an imprint.
But I think we did a pretty good job smoothing her out.
Yeah, the two queen-size beds, a nice chair over here with a footrest.
And then, of course, if you have more than four people,
they have the classic Disney pull-out couch.
Which, thankfully, this time comes with instructions, so we won't repeat the boardwalk incident.
Keep pulling! Keep pulling! Wait a minute, I don't think that's how this works.
Oh, no, then you push it,
and then after you push it, it's a couch again.
Pull the strap,
and it folds into a...
Oh, wait, you gotta unhook these things here, and... Oh!
And... Anyway,
there you go. Nice, comfortable bed.
Maybe it's just supposed to be like this, a one-person bed.
Oh, yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
Up, Look at that. Presto changeo. Now you've got sleeping space for five. There's even a bed for grandma.
Now, one thing I really like in here is that there are a lot of outlets
that also have USB ports.
When you come here like me with 80,000 different kinds of batteries and laptops
and phones and all kinds of things to charge,
that can be very helpful. Look, you can even plug in your banana.
That's just a joke. Please don't plug in your bananas.
Ooh, now look at this lamp right here. Look at this little tiki guy. I'm not sure if that's Polynesian or Melanesian in style,
but I like it.
Look at this. Plenty of roomy drawers for you to keep your drawers in.
Wow, I never unpack like this.
That's all Allie's doing right there.
Ooh, and
I love when they do this. A lot of hotels have the desk up against the wall like this.
But if you're like me and you have to do hours of work on a laptop in the hotel,
sometimes you'd like to be able to glance up at the TV, you know?
Maybe eat something in the room and still be able to see the TV.
And that is why I love when they do this. They include
a sneaky little
hideaway table that you can roll wherever you want.
I can laptop on the couch.
I can read a magazine from the chair.
I can eat grapes while I'm laying in bed.
I can eat a banana.
Or look at this, you can even push the table between the beds
to create a little bridge.
Oh, you think I'm crazy now, but this'll come in handy. I'll explain later.
Check this out. Back towards the door are little closets here
to help you get a little mood lighting at night.
Very roomy for your extra hats and linens and irons.
Or extra warm shirts for those cold Florida winters.
And then in between, you got your coffee maker and your fridge,
drawers full of stuff.
All in all, pretty nice setup.
The only thing that's missing that I always wish they would have
in every hotel room everywhere is a microwave.
I know some of the DVC rooms do have them, but I wish they all did.
Because if you have food allergies like me, it's nice to have the option to make your own food in the room.
All right, and now for the room I know you all want to see.
The room with the throne.
The glorious and actually quite roomy
traditional Polynesian bathroom, complete with a shower tub combination,
plenty of mirrors,
lots of light. Wait a minute, why is it so dark?
Oh, yeah. Duh.
His and hers sinks, or hers and hers, or his and his, or they and them.
Got your nice thatch-covered Kleenex.
Your Disney Resort's H2O soap on this little platter here.
All in all, I'd say it's pretty nice. The bathtub is comfortable, the shower head is nice, the water pressure's good.
But my favorite part of the bathroom has to be the turtle wall.
It's just so brown, and there's so many turtles.
This whole motif can be really helpful
when you need to sit down and think brown. Think brown!
And great Scott! Look at this!
Ooh, extra wipey wipey.
Anyway, there you have it.
Now, room rates at the Polynesian, like all the other Disney resorts,
are both seasonal and kind of depend
on how far in advance you book the room.
I feel like the last time I had a room here, it was a little bit nicer, and I'll link that episode down below.
And I remember coming here in the dead middle of summer
and snagging that room for about $200 a night.
Plus, there's all kinds of weird discounts out there. If you're a DVC member, you can use points.
So that's why I don't want to set a fixed price on these rooms and say, oh, they cost this much.
Because they change all the time. Sometimes I want to stay at a Disney hotel and I look and it's like $500.
And then like a couple of weeks later, we'll hear from a friend that they stayed in that hotel
for pennies on the dollar.
So you really gotta try to look far ahead, stay sharp,
and hunt in the off season.
I really like all the decor in these rooms, even the older stuff,
especially at night when you dim the lamps and open up the windows here and see all the flickering, burning torches outside.
It really helps complete the illusion
that you've stepped out of the ordinary and onto some strange tropical island.
Oh, yeah, and by the way, the rooms on the ground floor and the top floor
also come with a little patio space.
Personally, I prefer the ground floor because then you could just walk right into your room like this.
But either or is good, and in this case,
our little patio area was especially awesome because not only could we hear the Spirit of Aloha show last night,
but from right here,
we've got a great view of the Magic Kingdom's castle and, of course, the fireworks.
Also, being at the very end of the very last building
meant that it was actually very private and very quiet over here, which was nice.
Altogether, this was a really nice stay.
Matter of fact, I'm kind of bummed now that we're switching hotels in the morning.
Especially because for some reason, the Polynesian has the most comfortable mattresses in the world.
I'm not even kidding. It's like sleeping on a cloud.
But a firm cloud with plenty of lumbar support.
Now, if this is all sounding pretty good to you, I should mention
that this room here does have one problem,
and it's kind of a big one.
As you know, many of the Polynesian islands are volcanic in nature,
and that means that every once in a while in this room,
suddenly and without warning, the floor can turn to lava! Oh my gosh, look! See? No one ever believes me! The floor is lava! Come on, Allie. See?
I told you the bridge was a good idea. They all said I was crazy. But who's crazy now, huh? Who's crazy now? Oh, thank goodness it turned back to carpet. Just in the nick of time.
Anyway, as long as you're brave enough to deal with periodic lava flare-ups,
the Polynesian gets a thumbs up.
Plus 3 gold stars and
2 rainbows, so, you know, that's pretty good.
All right, gang, well, we're switching rooms tomorrow,
and we've still got a lot to do and see here at Walt Disney World before we head home.
If you want to see more Polynesian stuff, there are other episodes linked down below, the bungalow tour, a different room tour,
plenty of other sweet adventures here.
But for now, I think we've done our duty.
We can hotel
and sleep well.
Air conditioner. It's getting a little warm.